We're gonna get started on our Bangs Island mussel dish.
We wash them individually, go through, make sure that there are no cracked ones, dead ones. If they're dead, they'll open, but if they are alive, they'll close up when you tap them again. It's closing, it's a live mussel. See that? So yeah, we take them, we saute them real quick with a little bit of olive oil and garlic and white wine. Not much to it, we don't season them with salt or pepper at this point because they're gonna get smoked and then marinated in all the flavor.
So it's a very simple play. It's a mussel on an egg. Deviled eggs are definitely a barbecue staple, and this was just our little take on it. And it was a way to combine, you know, local seafood with a little bit of the smoke from the smoker.
Just a kiss of smoke though, really. Oh, I've been wanting to use that line for a while now. All right, those are done for our purposes. We throw in some local seaweed into the pan to protect the mussels from the dry heat of the smoke. We'll put a layer of seaweed right on top of them. In the smoker, it just seems to help the product retain some moisture more than anything.
Maine has world-class ingredients, whether we're talking about lobsters, or shellfish, scallops, mussels. Exploring that with the barbecue was something we felt we had to do. We've got quite a bit of smoke on the actual top of the seaweed right now. It's got a little bit of smoke color, although a lot of these have that natural orange color, but that's exactly what we're looking for. So we'll take these guys out. We'll cool them down, we'll separate the meat from the shell, and then we'll put them back on a marinade where they'll sit until served. All we're trying to do is get the mussel out as round and whole as possible.
So there we have our smoked mussel meat, and now it's ready for the marinade. Very simple, chili oil and our Terlingua house-made habanero hot sauce round out the flavor there. They're ready to be served on the eggs.
It's 5 a.m. We are going through the big meats. We gotta get the big meats on first. These guys are our pork shoulders, AKA the Boston butts. We gotta get rid of some of the extraneous fat just for an even cook. And then we're gonna score it and season it. And that's about it. The scoring, when these things cook, what tends to happen is the shoulder blade section tends to separate from like the copa, like part of the neck. You wanna give it away to do it in a more attractive way. All we're gonna do is add a little bit of our house season, which is top secret. Just kidding, it's mostly coffee and brown sugar. A couple extra spices, cumin, chili powder, a little garlic and onion, because it goes boom in your mouth. And then she's ready for the barbecue. Brisket, mainstay of Texas barbecue. These guys are sourced in Nebraska. They're prime briskets. And then you just start carving it down and removing the fat that is not gonna render itself. You know, usually when you get these briskets, you're trimming off about at least 25% of the overall weight. So you might be getting briskets for $4 a pound, but after trim and after the cook, you know, you're down to 50% of your products. I learned in my backyard in Austin, Texas. I took a barbecue course at universityofphoenix.com and passed with flying colors. No, I'm just kidding. Me and my wife lived there for about 8 or 9 years. Started barbecuing in the backyard, watching UT football games. All right, so this guy is pretty much ready to go. We will chuck this guy on the smoker.
We're doing our smoked lobster tostada, and we have some local Maine lobsters from Casco Bay here. They're live and kicking. We steam them for about 8 minutes to get the meat to release from the shell. They're just barely cooked, and then we finish them on our outdoor wood smoker. The heart and core of the restaurant is Pliny's smoked meats and seafood. And we've sort of come together to create a pretty awesome thing that seems really popular. People love it. They're just about there. They need a touch more heat, but that heat's gonna come from the smoker.
Yeah, most of what we do is sort of a holy trinity of one is the smoke, one is like the Latin American, Mexican, Caribbean style of will, and then the other is the local product. And so whatever we do, you know, highlights one of those three things, if not combines them all.
So here are lobsters, soft shells. They've been cooked just barely. The remainder of their cooking will happen on the smoker. So we split them right down the center. Crack the claws a little bit because the claws take a little longer. The shell insulates the meat, but with a little crack, the smoke gets in there and can also permeate the meat as far as flavor is concerned. So from here, we're going to clean out the guts and slather them in our guajillo chili and garlic butter, and then onto the smoker they go.
I met Will 6-7 years ago. His vision of what he wanted to do with a restaurant, representing a lot of his experience in Mexico, the combination of Texas and Mexico being so close, having so much or overlapping culture and history and spices and flavors and profiles, was something that we were really interested in exploring. Check on these lobsters, and they are done. We are gonna get these guys off. The lobster, you know, it's so delicate and cooks so quick, and we're cooking it at such a low temperature. We still want to make sure that it's not overcooking. You can, you know, overcooking lobster is, it can get pretty rubbery, pretty leathery, pretty tough. So just don't want to do that. Will, you want to pick some stirs, man?
Do I ever? Yeah, we're just getting the meat ready. It's still going to get warmed up again in our guajillo butter. The same butter we drizzled on here for the smoker. This is Spanish mackerel, a beautiful, slightly oily fish that holds up really well to our smoke. And we're using it for our smoked fish dip. We don't often see a lot of fish or seafood, for that matter, in barbecue restaurants, but being on the coast, we really try and showcase some of nature's bounty. I'll gut it and take the head off. Cut a couple slices into the flesh to let the marinade permeate a little bit. So this is our fish marinade for our smoked fish dip. Some fresh garlic and fresh thyme, a little bit of our house hot sauce, a bunch of fresh lime juice, some olive oil, salt, pepper. And they are ready for the smoker.
We're making barbecue in Maine. It's not easy to do. It's not meant to be here in a lot of ways. These steel smokers give off a lot of heat. When it's 90 degrees out, it's not a big deal. Recuperating it is not a problem, but when it's 0 degrees, which it is a lot of times up here, it makes it difficult. This is a reverse flow style smoker. Firebox is on the side, but the difference between a one directional is the smokestack is on the same side. So the smoke comes out of the firebox and goes through the baffle around this end and then across the surface of the meats in the chamber out the smokestack. I was lucky to find this 500 gallon tank. It's massively thick, it's over a half inch thick. And we added a Maine style firebox. It's a Warner firebox. You know, they're typically used for heating houses, but with the efficiency of this and bringing the reverse flow, we thought we could get enough flow and heat energy to really cook pretty efficiently, and so far it's working. Spanish mackerel coming off the smoker. So we'll cool these suckers down, remove the meat, and get it marinated up. This is Tommy. He's been developing a lot of our sausage program as we speak. And today we're gonna take our chorizo verde and stuff it in some of these Cavendish quail. These are local to Vermont. These are called semi-boneless, the way that they're broken down. So they have the legs and the wing bones, but they have no breastbone or anything else. So we're gonna fill these with the sausage and basically cook them until the sausage is at a food safe temperature. Quail's not something you typically see on a barbecue menu, neither is mussels or lobsters or anything else. And we're just trying to work with what we've got locally. I'm gonna put these on, and then I've gotta wrap and temp the meats, like the big meats that have been on since about 5:30, 6 o'clock. Be fairly quick about it. Quails are on, it's about 2 o'clock. We are gonna start checking the big meats and wrapping them up, push them through the stall, and hopefully get them off the smoker in a little bit. All right, these pork butts have been on for about 8 hours. They're pretty close to being done. So we're just gonna wrap them up, retain what's left of the moisture. Barbecue is an exercise of getting rid of moisture. These guys lose about 40% of their weight over the course of a cook. And that weight is water. So as they're cooking, they're sweating. It keeps the temperature down. That's called the stall. Wrapping these meats help sort of propel it beyond that point. Well, I think the biggest difficulty in adapting the culture in Maine to what is typical of Texas barbecue is the idea that it sells out. So we sort of had to introduce the idea, you know, when it's gone, it's gone. And we pissed off a lot of people, and now we've got the market to sort of make some extra production. So we don't ever run out anymore. All right, these quails are looking pretty good. They've been on for about an hour and a half and they are ready to go. Awesome. Food's always been important in my family. I made a decision early on. I was either gonna go into architecture or food, and I figured if I go into architecture, I'll be able to explore good food on the other side of the table. But after almost a decade in architecture and transitioning to Maine, we just had an opportunity to reinvent ourselves a little bit. That's part of what Maine's about. And we just took advantage of that. And we threw our hats into the ring and went from a backyard self-education barbecue to a restaurant. And thank God I had Wilson to help guide me through some of that process. With Terlingua, I think we really wanted to transport people to a certain part of the world, bringing some of the vibe that we experienced down in Austin and that part of Texas. It's very simple food, but there's a lot to it.